Have a few extra cards lying around? Looking to turn your rotating staples into a Theros booster box? Check out Channel Fireball's online buy list. We offer the most competitive prices on all of your unwanted cards, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a hefty 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's fast, it's easy, and as LSV would say, it's good value.
Hi everyone, this is Paul on our Theros draft. This pack is actually pretty hard. I think the two best cards are by far the Guardian and the Whip. They're both black, and we'll certainly be putting the person next to us black. But I don't think it can be helped. I don't think taking the Asp, which is the next best card, is a good plan here. Because these cards are much better. I think the Guardian is probably better than the Whip. Yeah, I'll try the Whip. It's a rare. But I think it's definitely a possibility that a Gorgon is just better. Also, I think the Whip is more of splashy than the Gorgon, so if people see the Whip, they'll definitely go black. Whereas if they see the Gorgon, they might, you know, just take the green card because you took a green card before. It's not as obviously powerful. I do think it's more powerful than the Whip, though. I think at the PT, I'll probably take the Gorgon, but I never played with this card in draft before, and I kind of want to try it. So here, I think it's between Sip and Cure. Both happen to be black, which is good, I guess, but also passing like Disciple and stuff like that. Obviously, Sip is more of a late game card, Cure more of an early game card that you can also use in the late game sometimes. I think I would definitely rather have the first Sip or the first Cure. I might prefer having 1-1 over 2, but yeah, let's just take this. Okay, here I think possible picks are probably Divine Verdict and Trident Tactics. I think Trident Tactics offers a bigger upside if you have like heroic and stuff, but if I'm planning to be black, I'm just not gonna get that upside. Unless I open Agent of the Fates. I don't think the blue cards are enough. Like, this card is good in blue-green and in blue-white. Especially blue-white, not that much in blue-green. I think I'm just going to take Divine Verdict here. I think I actually like black-white as a combination a lot. See, because it has this card. but right now, I think I have to take Nimbus Naiad. As much as I think this card is very good in black-white, Nimbus Naiad is one of the best commons. Definitely top 5 commons and much better than this card. So, I guess I'll just take it. Maybe I will go blue-white after all. Huh, interesting. So this card, the Sentry, is very good. But I haven't seen a lot of black after pack 2, and it did pass a lot of black, so it's dangerous. A big black card here. Because this is not effectively a black card. You know, there's no signal that black is open in any level. Because it's a gold card. I think I can still take it. Because the alternative is taking a Divine Verdict, which is not that exciting. Okay, so there's nothing here. I could just take a 3-2. I could take a Giant. I think I don't really want to be red at this point. Isn't really, like, red is only good if it's aggressive. It doesn't really match well with anything that I have. I'll just take it a 3-2. There's an Acolyte. I like this card. I'm not playing it. I think I can just take Vanquish to fall here. It's not super exciting. I already have a Sip for a 6 casting cost card. But those black-white decks tend to stall the game a little bit, and then it's good to have a card that removes, well, almost anything. Generally anything that you want to remove. Yeah, I think 2-mana 2-1s or 2-mana 1-3s are just not very exciting in this format. I guess I'll take Glare, which is a good sideboard card. So Viper's Kiss or the 3-2? Probably 3-2. And 1-2. Okay, yeah, we're definitely not seeing a lot of black, and we'll probably not see a lot of black next back. It might not be necessary if we see like a lot of white, but so far white cards are pretty mediocre. I mean, white is a very mediocre color outside of its best cards, which are very good. Take the grit. Yeah, take this. I guess there's still a chance that I go blue white. That's not a very good chance. Or like green white or red white. Fine. I'll take a 2/3 or two. Sorry. Okay, probably not playing two of those, but we'll sideboard it. And regret taking the sip now that I got two of those. I'd rather have the cure. Okay. Phalanx Leader is the best card here by a significant, significant amount, I think. Grey Merchant is obviously very good with whip. I mean, it combos with it in many levels. And a card that is more suited to control. But again, I don't think I'm seeing a lot of black, so this is probably not going to be very powered up. I mean, I already have like a whip, which powers it up almost enough. Phalanx Leader is a better card. It's definitely a better card. It's like an insanely good card. But it doesn't really go well with anything that I have. Like, I don't have cheap creatures and I don't have heroic spells. And I could start taking heroic spells, but they don't really match well with anything that I have, so I have to start over. So if I'm gonna take the Grey Merchant here, even though I think it's an abstract and much worse card. And not as well positioned in this draft, honestly, because I think it just goes better with everything that I have. Like, I think trying to get a Phalanx Leader deck to work at this moment is going to be harder than trying to get a Grey Merchant deck to work. And we've been rewarded, kind of. I think it's going to take all Grey Merchants from now on. No Grey Merchants? I'm very bad. Okay, I think taking to 1/4 is probably just better than taking the rescue here. Any of those cards might will, they're both generally like not good unless they're in very specific archetypes. The rescue could be good with two Grey Merchants and maybe even a third next pack, but my deck is already kind of clunky and I don't want another clunky card. Like, I want a card that makes me survive to cast the clunky card I already have. Yeah, another one of those. This card is not actually bad. I mean, it does take a specific deck to play with it, and also against a specific deck of sorts. But it's definitely not bad. I'm gonna take the Q here, though. I think I wanna have early game spells. Okay, this pack is quite good. We can take this color off a Thriller or the 3/3 for 2. This color is a better card. I do have two Grey Merchants, so this drains for one extra. But I don't think that's actually that relevant. I think I'd rather have just had the 1/4. I'm taking an Asp here. Yeah, I don't want people playing that against me. Yeah, that's a reasonably late hot played. Obviously, I can't play it. I don't think. I think I was gonna take God's Willing. I might not play it, but maybe I will play it. Do I want a centaur ever? Eh. Can I screw myself and mill stuff for whip? Okay, so I don't really want Ordeal. I don't think that Black Ordeal is that good, and obviously I don't have a deck suited for it, so I'm just gonna take the 3/3 Defender. Which is quite good. I mean, if I have a bunch of 1/4s that drain and some Grey Merchants, then and a flyer, then it's probably gonna get the job done. Like, it just holds the 4/2 mana cries heal them.